25 years of TV patrol. Now we're talking with Labor Secretary Rosalinda Baldoz. TUCP is on the line. Alan Tanhusay, good morning to you, Alan.
Good morning, Karen. Good morning kay Secretary Baldoz.
Okay. All right, sir, ang petition niyo po for NCR is a 90 peso across the board wage increase, correct?
Yes, ma'am. Tama
okay.
Po yan.
Very don't be technical, no. Ano po ang dahilan at umabot kayo sa calculation na 90 pesos a day increase?
Meron na po kasing supervening events. Unang-una sa pagtaas ng oil and the oil increase pushes the gasoline, the diesel, lalong-lalo na po itong LPG. At pag tumaas po itong mga prime commodities na ito, itutulak din niya ang presyo, ang halaga ng mga basic commodities, ang basic needs ng isang pamilyang Pilipino.
Magkano na ba, sir, ang itinaas ng LPG mula nung huling increase ninyo para ma-define niyo po ito as a supervening event?
Sa LPG pa lang, Karen, kung pag-uusapan natin yan, tumaas ang LPG na more than 200 pesos since...
Talaga? Ano
January?
To yung per ano? Per 200 pesos per ano, sir?
Per 11 kilogram cylinder tank.
Oo, so 200 pesos ang increase within the year already?
Yes, pinag-uusapan pa lang natin dito yung tanke within Metro Manila.
Oo.
Hindi pa natin pinag-uusapan dito yung LPG na binibenta sa probinsya, sa Visayas at sa Mindanao.
Oo. Pero parang ang mahirap, Alan, iba ata ang kahulugan ng supervening event sa TUCP at sa gobyerno. I think, was it Secretary, the BSP who said that wala pang supervening event?
No, yung wage board.
The wage board, the wage board.
Na nakaupo ang TUCP representative, dalawa ang sa labor, dalawang sa employer, kasama ng DOLE, ang DTI at saka NEDA.
Uh-oh.
So, ever since ang decision ng wage board, pag sinabing supervening event, very sustained ang increase that it would already breach or parang exceed that the maximum 5% projected inflation rate.
Okay.
Ayun na nga, nagkataon na even up to now, February 2, hindi pa umaabot yung inflation rate ng NCR sa 3%.
Okay, all right. Alan, your reaction. Inflation at NCR has not reached 3% yet.
Unang-una, Karen, sa supervening events, ano, dito nga, nakita na naman ninyo, no? Nagkakaiba ang definition ng Trade Union Congress, ang labor movement. Magkaibang definition with the government, ano? So, ang basis kasi ng TUCP, we are reflecting the sentiments of the workers mula dito sa baba.
Okay.
Ikalawa, we maintain that there are supervening events, there are extraordinary situations that warrants an increase of minimum basic pay in Metro Manila.
Okay.
Ikalawa, itong inflation na sinasabi Secretary Baldoz, with due respect, ma'am, ang inflation na kinukot ng BSP, ang inflation na kinukot ng DOLE, ay isang buwan lang, February. Ang basis ng aming petition ay namin yung consumer price index simula noong June hanggang December 2011.
Okay.
Hanggang sa present.
All right. Well, I know the increase for NCR is 90 pesos, but right now the wage board says that the possible increase that could be tackled, yung posibleng ibigay, well, Secretary Baldoz has said it's only really what you can expect is a low of a 13 pesos increase a day or a high of 21 pesos. Last year, your increase was 22. With the calculations, ang possibility lang daw is the high of 21 pesos increase.
Karen, we're using the projected inflation rate, no?
Uh-oh.
There are other factors that the board would like to consider, and that's the reason why there is a need for public hearing. Mm-mm. So official naman yung projection na yun ng Central Bank, and yun lang ang basis nung sinasabi ko, no? The board, I think.
Not the board.
The board, no? Because you're asking kung posible. As Secretary of Labor, actually, I sit as chair of the commission,
yes,
which would affirm the existence of the supervening event.
Yes.
And if there is a wage order, ina-approve din niya,
yeah,
ng commission. And there is negotiation among the members of the board based on the different socioeconomic indicators. Atiis lang yung inflation rate.
Uh-oh.
So
the BSP determines that.
And the BSP determines.
Okay.
And that is
there
official.
There can be many calculations on the inflation rate.
That's why, uh-oh, we can say on that basis, you can compute na ito yung possible range if you are talking of adjusting the minimum wage using inflation rate.
Uh-oh. All right. Alan, your reaction?
Ang basis po kasi ng date na ginagamit namin sa gobyerno din.
Uh-oh. Anong gobyerno? Saan sa gobyerno? BSP ba? Sinong nagkalkula?
Kinonsider namin yung data ng BSP, ng NEDA, ng DTI. Pero ang pinaka malaking factor na kinonsider namin ay yung data coming from National Wage NWPC, no? So sa kanila rin ang mga data na hinihain namin, no? Ang batihan ng aming petisyon.
Okay. All right, Alan, we don't have enough time, but I want to ask you, ano ba ang panawagan mo? I know that you'll be taking the wage petition, this discussion, it's going to be tackled now after the May 26th anniversary. So some small and medium enterprises have said 90 pesos is too high for NCR. Posibleng magsara daw ang ibang negosyo if it's given itong 86 pesos in Calabarzon or Cavite and 90 pesos in NCR. Alan?
Unang-una, Karen, hindi gusto ng mga manggagawa, lalong-lalo na ang TUCP, na magsara ang mga kumpanya. Pero pinag-aaralan ko namin yan bago namin inihiyain. Kinonsider namin yung viability ng mga company. At ang 90 pesos na yan po ay reflecting ng deep-seated need ng ating mga workers at ng kanyang pamilya.
No.
So, ang sinasabi nila magsasara, yan po ay pure blackmail to us. Kasi pwede naman silang mag-file ng exemption. No? Pwede silang mag-file ng exemption kung hindi nila kaya magtaas ng sahod.
Pero baka maraming mag-file ng exemption, di ganun din yun, Alan?
Hindi po. According to the last previous data po ng DOLE, 80 to 90% po ang nag-comply nung previous wage order na 22 pesos. So,
okay.
Only a few had filed for exemption.
Oo. All right. Well, Alan, thank you very much. I hope to have you on Head Start one of these days. Siguro good luck po sa inyo.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you po for this opportunity and good morning po kay Secretary Baldoz.
Okay. All right. Now, questions from Facebook. We don't have enough time, but I'll put one in. Laurelyn asks, are contractual employees allowed to work for more than 6 months?
Yes.
Dapat.
If,
oh, nga.
If the project where he is being hired will have a period for completion up to 1 year, then he should be hired for the period of 1 year. Very
yang
technical.
Yung six months na yan ba, Secretary? Hanggang kailan lang yan pwede? Kasi alam naman natin yung ibang department stores forever naka-6 months.
Karen, it really depends. Now, when you say contractual employee, I can hire you because of your expertise.
Yes.
And if the program will only run for 2 months, why will I hire you for 5 months
Pero
or
iba
six
naman
months?
Yun, ma'am.
So, iba-iba nga. That's why case-to-case basis.
Yes, yes.
We have to understand the facts and circumstances. Pero yung hina-hire ka...
Sales lady, cashier.
Na ang iyong trabaho... continues
yeah.
to run, tapos i-chop ka ng 5-5-5, then yun ang hindi tama. Yun ang hindi natin pinapayagan.
Saan sila pwede mag-report?
Sa regional office, kung dito sa Manila, sa NCR regional office ng DOLE.
Okay. Frederick asks, how can you help our nurses? Most hospitals in the country are understaffed and nurses are underpaid. Quickly, ma'am.
Well, sa government hospitals, may ginagawa na ang gobyerno, no? So, nag-fill up na ng mga plantilla at meron tayong tinatawag na RN Hills na 10,000 were hired under the DOH payroll yan. And, but admittedly, kulang pa din talaga. No? And even in the private hospitals, mukhang may kakulangan pa rin. And so, I think the hiring continues naman for the private hospitals. But yung sa government hospitals, nag-start na rin mag-hire. I'm not sure kung na-fill up lahat na ang plantilla as of now.
Okay, Donnie asks, last year, DOH Secretary Ona issued a memo banning volunteer nurses on public hospitals. What can you do to completely stop voluntarism among our nurses?
Actually, if you really want to gain exposure or experience, because right from college, wala kang ang work experience, then...
But they take advantage, the hospitals.
The abusive practice, that was really cut off. And that is the reason why Secretary Ona issued that memorandum order. And in place nga, if the hospital really needs the services, don't get volunteers. You get the nurses under the RN Hills program ng government where we pay 10,000 a month.
Okay. Kilusang Mayo Uno tweets, pahabol po ito. Based on Ibon Foundation, 125 peso wage hike only means 12% cut in the total profits of all establishments in the Philippines. So sabi ng Kilusang Mayo Uno, based on Ibon Foundation, 125 wage hike is actually possible. Okay, your reaction?
Pag profit na ng company to company.
Meaning hindi sila magsasara. Yun ang study, ang mababawasan lang is 12% of cut of their profit.
We're talking here of minimum wage, no? Yung over and above in relation to the profit, that really has to be negotiated. But minimum wage is for all.
And so it's 125 too high?
I think, as I said, I can only talk about the what has been officially released as projection. The other factors that NEDA will share with the Regional Wage Board, hindi pa naman naka-factor yon. But I think 125 pesos is high.
Okay, Pepito asks, pag ang office mo ay NCR, pero ang trabaho niyo po ay nasa province, alin ba ang dapat na sunding minimum wage?
Sa probinsya, kung nasaan siya. Kung nasa Cavite na siya, yung i-release na minimum wage o yung current minimum wage ng Region 4A.
Oo. Okay.
Kung siya nakapaloob.
Alright, okay. So definitely, ma'am, I think we have to have you on the show again. Because your next discussion will be after May 26, so this will be ongoing.
Actually, today, the Wage Board of NCR, I was told, is meeting to schedule some informal public consultation. Kasi the idea is, after May 26, there will be a notice of public hearing. And hopefully, if they can cut the public hearing into just one. Kasi may mga informal na before May 26. And I said that is a very welcome decision. But they will discuss that in today's meeting of the Wage Board of NCR.
Okay, so good luck to you and good luck to our workers. Ma'am, hindi na nga natin na pag-usapan ng Syria.
Susunod.
When you return,
okay.
Sa susunod.
Thank you,
that's
Karen.
Headstart today. I'm Karen Davila. Replay of Secretary Rosalinda Baldoz's interview today will be at 6:30 p.m. tonight on ANC. Have a good day, everyone. I'll see you again tomorrow.